to battle the buffalo demon. And Durga kicked his ass. So Durga was the buffalo soldier, fighting on arrival, fighting for survival. Buffalo soldier, Durga. Right? And so you can see that. And you know, why does she have 10 arms? Because, and I don't know if you noticed, but Shiva only has 4 arms. She has 10, which tells you what? That women can do more, right? Women can do more. Because my kids are pain in the ass, you know, especially when they're young. You know, daddy, can you do this? Daddy, can you help me? Can you, daddy, can you give me 10? Hey, I only have?
2 hands.
I only got 2 hands? Go see Durga, she's got 10. So she can do a lot. She can do a lot. Her vahana, as you can see, a lion, which makes sense because she's very strong. Sometimes it's a tiger. There you go. Right, so if you see this goddess battling the buffalo demon, right, vahana, lion, tiger, chances are this is Durga, right, the goddess of justice, champion fighter for the weak. Right. All kinds of stories about Durga. Here's one more. There was a guy, I forget what he did, but he's a terrible guy. And because of his evil deeds, he was destined for a terrible rebirth. Anyway, on his deathbed, he repented. And he called out to Durga for help. Please save me, Durga. And Durga heard his plea and raced to go and save him, but got there a split second too late. And so then he died, and because of his negative karma, he was immediately reborn as a rat. And so Durga said, you know what, he repented. And so even though he's a rat, I'm going to take care of him. I'm going to make the rat my special messenger. And so the rat today is seen as a messenger of Durga. And so there are temples dedicated to Durga where rats are prominent. Right? So you may have heard of the rat temple, where there's this temple, a big net is like over the temple so that birds cannot come in and pluck off the rats, or cats cannot enter. Right? And so it's filled with rats. Right? And if you want Durga to help you out, you treat the rats nice and they will carry your messages. And of course, Durga likes kids, so, you know, the rats like their kids too. Right? So if you see this, you know, don't go to City Mint or Home Depot and get, you know, those traps. This is Durga. This temple is dedicated to Durga. So far, so good? So again, Shakti is the feminine principle, the universe, power. And Shakti expresses itself in the goddesses. And so women, we said, can light up our lives. They bring us good luck. Women are beautiful. Women are strong. What else? Women are smart, artistic, cultured, right? Isn't that so? Yeah. Sarasvati is the goddess of culture, the arts, education. And it's easy to tell Sarasvati because, you know, you can see she has this musical instrument. It's not a Gibson SG, it's a sitar. And her vahana, sometimes swan, sometimes a peacock. Right? But she's the goddess of culture, arts, education. She's become so popular that she has spread outside of India. So for example, she's also venerated in Japan. Right? And so I don't know if you know the Japanese religions, but there are something called the 7 gods of good luck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And among the 7 gods of good luck, the only female is Sarasvati. So here she is. I mean, she's put on a little weight and gotten older, but that's okay. Because you know, back then, no more airlines, huh? No more airlines. So by the time from India to Japan, yeah, you know, gotten older, put on weight, that's okay. Look at this guy. Same thing. And these, you know, they're on a boat. The 7 gods of good luck are on a boat. They came from China, actually. There used to be, in China they have 8. But I guess when they crossed over the sea, 1 fell overboard. So only 7 made it. Yeah. There were two guys in a boat, Big Pete, Big Pete, and Wee Pete. Big Pete fell overboard. So who was left?
Wee Pete.
Yeah, there are two guys in a boat, Big Pete and Wee Pete. And Big Pete fell overboard. So who was left?
Wee Pete.
Yeah, there are two guys in a boat, Big Pete and Wee Pete. Do you get it? Wee Pete, Wee Pete. Oh, well. Anyway, Sarasvati is so popular in Japan that people look to Sarasvati for help. And so look at this. Sarasvati has got this woman's back. See that? So women light up our lives. They bring us good luck. Women are beautiful. Women are strong, champion warriors of justice. Women are smart, they're artistic, right? Culture, what else? Women are mean, they're evil, they're short-tempered, they're jealous, they go nuts, they're unforgiving, they're vicious, they're dangerous, suspicious, threatening, scary. Huh? Yeah. That is Kali. Kali is the goddess of destruction. Oh my goodness. She is very scary. You don't mess with Kali. Kali, the wife of Shiva. In India, only at Kali temples do they still make blood sacrifices. She's bloodthirsty. I'm not sure if you can see this here. This is, she's wearing a garland of severed heads. Yeah, they all are victims, severed heads. And see her skirt? Severed limbs. Look at that. Yeah, blood all over the place. Right. Today, in India, they still make blood sacrifices of Kali. But today in India, they will sacrifice chickens or goats. But in the past, it is said, they sacrifice not just chickens and goats to Kali, but sacrifice what?
Humans.
Humans. Right? It is human sacrifices in the past to Kali. But over time, this stopped. How come? Because after a while, it got tough to get human sacrifice. I don't know if you ever tried getting a human sacrifice. Kind of tough. You know, so they go on the street. Excuse me, what are you doing today? Oh, no plans. Would you like to be sacrificed? No. And so over time, it got tough to get a human sacrifice. And so special followers of Kali had the job of beating people up, knocking them out, so that they could be sacrificed. And those special followers who had the job of beating people up and knocking them out to be sacrificed were called
thugs.
And our English word
thug
comes from this. Our English word thug comes from this. And so, but again, today, chickens are sacrificed, goats are sacrificed. And so, you know, here's this temple here, here's a girl, right? And Kali descends upon the girl, so the spirit of Kali is in the girl. And then they make offerings to the girl, right? Give her blood. And looks like she's full, right? And what's going on? We talked about this. Remember yoga? What's the most popular form of yoga? This will be on the exam. What's the most popular form of yoga?
Bhakti.
Bhakti. And we said you have murti, embodiment, here. She's murti. And you make puja, right? Make puja. And then you get prasad, the blessings. She performs blessings for the community. So you can see the practice, right, in even contemporary Hinduism. By the way, do you know which movie was the first movie in the history of movies to receive a PG-13 rating? It happened in the 80s. Because when I was growing up, you didn't have PG-13. When I was growing up, you just had movies were rated G, PG, R, and then X. And those were the ratings. But the very first movie to get a PG-13 rating. Anyone know? Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. Anybody ever seen this movie?
Sure.
Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom was the first movie to get a PG-13 rating. Why? Well, when the Motion Picture Association of America, MPAA, previewed Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom, they gave it an R rating. Initially, it gave it an R rating. Right? But Steven Spielberg got upset and said, you cannot give my movie an R rating, because if you do that, then kids can't come, I'm not going to make money, so you got to give it a PG rating. But the MPAA, Motion Picture Association of America, said, no, we can't give this a PG rating. Because there's a scene in Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom that is so violent that it's not PG. And you know what scene that is? Is it familiar? There's this guy, I don't know if you can tell, but this is a heart. He has ripped out the heart from this guy. Look, he's not happy. You see? He's not happy. And so there's a scene where this guy, this priest, goes in to the man's chest, rips out his heart. And what does he do with the heart? He gives it away for Christmas. Last Christmas. No, what does he do with the heart? Anybody see this movie?
Took a bite out of it. Huh?
He offers it to Kali.
Oh.
There's Kali. He offers it to Kali. And so because of this scene, they created a new rating, PG-13. So Kali is so powerful. She is the only goddess or god who is so powerful. She can change the movie rating system in America. No other god can change the movie rating system in America. She's very powerful. So far, so good?
Yeah.
There are all kinds of stories about Kali. Here's one. So Kali, as we said, is the wife of Shiva, right? And one day Kali's going nuts. And when Kali goes nuts, you just got to get out of her way, because she's going to kill you. And so all the gods were just hiding. They're just cowering in fear. And, you know, Kali's just going nuts. And so, you know, they didn't know what to do. They're so scared. They're waiting for Shiva to come home to maybe try and calm her down. And finally Shiva comes home, and they rush up to Shiva. They say, Shiva, 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 thank goodness you're home. Thank goodness you're home. And Shiva says, what's up, guys? What happened? Oh, Shiva, your wife Kali is going nuts. And Shiva says, oh, shit, let's get out of here. And they said, no, Shiva, you have to try and calm her down. Only you can calm her down. And Shiva says, no, guys, you don't understand. When she's like this, let's just get out of here. We just get out of here. Just leave her alone. Just go. No, please, Shiva, you're the only one. You're the only chance. We're going to calm her down. She's going to destroy everything else. Please, Shiva, please try. Please, Shiva, you're our last chance. And she goes, well, okay, I'll try, but you don't know how she is. And so he walks into the room and tries to calm her down and says, honey, and Kali kills Shiva. How is that? Shiva is the god of creation and destruction. Shiva is one of the most powerful gods, if not the most powerful god. But he gets killed by Kali. Kali kills Shiva. But is Shiva really dead?
No.
Even in death, he still has an erection. Because remember we said last night, it's Shiva's erection that keeps the world going, right? That's why the sacred... All right, so even in death, he still has his erection. And so some people ask, what's Kali's Bahana? What does she ride? I don't know. Anyway. How was that? Questions? Any questions, Helen? No? I thought Parvati is the wife of Shiva. Right? But Kali is the wife of Shiva? How can that be?
Durga.
And so, The answer is like this. I, you know, that, you know, because they said, does he have, how many wives does he have? I only have one wife. I only have one wife. Sometimes my wife is Parvati. Sometimes my wife is Kali. So, again, different expressions. Okay. Oh yeah. Other time. Oh yeah. So on Wednesday we'll finish Hinduism. We'll do the teachings, and then on Friday we have our second exam. Thank you for coming. Hope the rest of the day is a good one. See you Wednesday. Maybe.